coming to you live from Plug Hit Studios in beautiful Largo, Florida. We are keeping you plugged in with episode 253 of F5 Live.
This week, Cheese Karma gets an upgrade, Verizon brightens up Florida, and once again, Germany thinks Google has crossed the line. Say Nick.
Nick.
There's an interesting, slightly different than normal smell in the studio tonight.
Indeed. It smells very like, very much like Jon Stewart.
It smells a lot like, springtime, I think.
Spring has sprung.
With a little bit of plastic and silicon in there.
Sorry, I didn't shave from my, or wash from my Tuesday nights. I didn't shave from my Tuesday night either, apparently. I don't know. You must be talking about that new tech smell. Let's change the subject.
I am.
Because, God, I think this show.
This show?
This show right here.
This one
right here is part of the Tech Podcast Network. If it's tech, it's here. I'm Nick.
And I'm Scott.
And we're here.
We are. And I had to think very hard about that once again.
At least you didn't mess this one up. And wherever you may be and however you may be accessing our show, whether it be Facebook, iTunes, Zune, or any other of our streaming services, thanks for making us part of your day. But of course, there is one place where you can get all of the content that we supply as soon as it comes out, and that's by going to f5live.tv and hitting the subscribe buttons on the right-hand side. Audio, video, and social, it's all there for your media consumption content.
Content.
Thanks. But there's one place we want them to be, and that's chatting with us live in the studio every Sunday night at 9 p.m. Eastern Time by going to f5live.tv/join us. Stay tuned in the chat room. Exclusive for our live listeners, the epic award-winning, spine-chilling, bone-tingling, ear-crumbling post-plug.
Post-plug.
For 10 minutes after the show. 10 minutes after the show. Chat with us off the record. Shows get posted. As soon as the show goes off the air, we edit it and then post it, so it's there for you early Monday morning. That's how it operates. What's up, Scott? It's like I just saw you the other night or something.
Yeah.
And the night before that.
I feel like we just did a show. I don't know why.
Wait, because we did.
Oh, well, that'll do it.
Now, we probably have a lot of new listeners and viewers that maybe have tuned in for the first time from that special edition show, and for that, I apologize.
Yes.
That is our 420 show. It gets crazy. There are two shows a year in which we can act like a fool, as Ludacris would say, and that is on the 420 show and during our anniversary show.
The rest of the year, we do it even though we're not allowed to.
Right. It makes a difference. So if you tuned in for Friday's show, I'm sorry. I really apologize. But
although it was probably the calmest one we've ever done.
Calmest, but most crazy at the same time. We had the strobe light going this year.
Yes.
We had the disco ball and the cans and five people in the room.
It started out with less, but...
Right. That's fine, though.
Grew with time.
With our show coming back to our regular schedule, you will find technology news, internet news, gaming news, and media news all for you, our loyal F5 Live listener and viewer, for that matter, because we're doing that now. With
now?
Our show. Yeah, we've been for a while. For like a year and a half now, right?
Yeah.
So with that, though, also comes the Epic Award-winning Pilch Point with actual Avram Pilch.
Yay!
Who, I don't know if you know this, Scott, but he is the online editorial director for Laptop Magazine, which is
I
still
have
in
no
business.
No idea. No. About either of those facts.
Nope. We did have the absolutely lovely Courtney Wallen from RVNN.TV fill in a week ago. As Avram had his wonderful Pilch Book Mini, his newly born son, Isaac. But Avram will be on the show tonight, and we'll talk about things that Isaac may not see when he gets older, so that'll be exciting.
Hoorah! Not for things he may not see, but just in general, hoorah.
As far as us, we're gearing up in a couple of months here, in just a couple of weeks here, for E3.
Yuppers!
F5 Live will be... kicking butt and taking names like never before at E3, and we encourage you to make sure you subscribe to our content and to our feeds to make sure you get the information as it happens. on your phone, computer, or tablet. Ironic how that works out that way. But we will be delivering the news like never before. You'll see more content. And actually, you will also get content from the HP event.
Yes.
As we're working on a way to make that happen, a couple of our wonderful people from RVNN.TV will be out there. So make sure you subscribe. You got to get out there and subscribe. It's the only way you can get our content. If you have a Roku or Boxy, we're out there too through TPN.TV, which is our tech podcast network. It's our mother network. I don't know. Father network? It's always sister network, never brother network. So is it mother network?
Parent is good enough.
It's not gender specific, huh?
Exactly.
But sister city, sister station, that's gender specific. Now we're being told by the chat room that we're getting shiny foreheads and lots of PF Red. Is that a sister restaurant to PF Chang's?
Yeah, it's right. Indian food. I apologize. That was terrible.
Lots of red in skin tones. All right, we'll have to work on that. Now, for those watching live, we are on Ustream and you can get our content there, but you can also get our content on YouTube. We usually post that up a few days after, roughly a couple days after the video is finalized and edited. It takes a lot to edit these hour-long HD videos, but we do record it in HD as well without ads on YouTube. YouTube.com, search for Plug Hits Live, which is our parent company, our own parent company that runs this. So make sure you subscribe there too.
Want to just make sure we.
Abram says he's booking down to the music.
You know, it's all good. I'm telling you. We saw Jon Stewart yesterday. We should talk about that for a little bit. Or not?
Too late now.
No. Well, he was awful. And I encourage you not to go see him.
No, it was a good show. definitely enjoyable.
Indeed.
Right up until the crazy woman at the end ruined his concentration.
And made him storm off.
Actually scared him off the stage, which is pretty impressive when you're in a theater that seats something like 2,500 people.
Yeah, it's a lot. I don't know how that happened. It was impressive.
I've never quite seen anything like that, where the audience decided that they wanted to be part of the show.
You see that at, like, improv shows. And you'll see that at small comedy clubs.
Yeah, not
with... We've been a part of some of it.
Not with professionals.
Nope.
It's very strange, but...
And it wasn't a Bob Saget show, to be fair.
Right.
Where it's expected.
The type of people that go to see Jon Stewart, I suppose, are... younger and less professional.
That's a good way to put it.
So... But he puts on a really good show.
It was great. It's just nice to hang out with people.
He's not nearly as political in person, which is nice. Because...
it would fend off a lot of people.
Yeah.
You can't do that. But it was good. What else is going on? I mean, there's not much else. Our season six?
Start?
I lose track of this. Our season six start fight. Comes up soon here.
Yes.
52, 104, 156.
Hit back real quick. Technically, it's 160. It's 260. But
is it? Where am I searching?
Right there. June 3rd was our first episode.
Oh, we're not doing by 52 anymore because we do more than 52 shows.
Exactly. It's not fair anymore. So our... That's the Sunday before E3.
Oh my god.
That is our first show from LA.
Scott, that is why we started to do 52 episodes. I remember this now. We had this discussion.
Nope.
No?
Because 52 used to put us in Miami.
It did, that's right. Because we would leave here, pack, and then go to Miami to do the show, or do it here, and then pack and then leave the next morning.
Yeah.
That was not fun either. I don't like the month of June. I think we do what some couples do and get married on one day and then get remarried on another day, and that's their new anniversary. A more convenient anniversary.
Well, how about this? How about we celebrate the end of our fifth season and not the beginning of our sixth? And we can do it...
our season finales.
Yes.
So we're making a claim now. Just like we made a claim when we hit episode 200. I said, is it
200?
I said, is it 214, 214, 214? And we decided 214, 215... I'm making a decree now. the voting members are in, and we have said that the end of season 5
is when we will celebrate.
Will be the celebration, which will be episode
something else.
Let's see. So it's 253, right?
Yep.
254. Five is off because it's Mother's Day.
We've got a Mother's
Five,
Day in there.
6, 7, 8. So 7. 257 is the end of season 5. That is May 27th. Pending any other holidays.
That's we'll our other know. Crazy episode.
I think it's episode 257, so make sure you tune in for that. And if you want to send out a shout out and a congratulations, you can do so by contacting us at contact@plughits.com. Make sure you go there. Send us a video clip. Send us an audio file. I don't care what it is.
Send us somebody who loves music.
Yeah. Do all of that.
An audio file.
We need those.
Grammar.
Audio or hi-fi is for idiots.
Like us.
But we have a lot of show. So with that, we should get into the topic.
Should we? Yeah, I guess we should. Tonight.
And I want to commend you again, Scott, for getting the opening right without having to look at it. It's impressive stuff.
It's a thing. I know. It's not. Most people can't do it, but I'm special that way.
I think what you're saying is most people should be able to do it.
Oh, indeed.
Let's get started. This week's news from the tubes on F5 Live is proudly powered by Riff Tracks. Scott.
Oh, that's me. No, I know who I am, I swear. Friday has not worn off
A-rated.
On me.
You shouldn't swear we're A-rated.
Oh, I'm sorry. I apologize to all of you listening who are A's. So Riff Tracks, the guys who used to do Mystery Science Theater 3000 are back, and this time not doing B-movies, because they can afford to do something else, unlike sci-fi. So, because of that, you've got movies like Twilight Saga, Breaking Dawn, Part 1, that they're able to make watchable.
That is impressive in and of itself.
Yes, because on its own, it's not watchable.
It's awful.
Captain America the First Avenger, however, was watchable on its own, and they make it funny, which it wasn't supposed to be.
That's okay, though.
Exactly. It's really great. You can go to the website and check out their shorts and their short films,
yep.
Including Super-Powered Revenge Christmas.
The Christmas retcon we've all been waiting for.
Thank goodness. It's about time.
We needed one of those.
They are doing a Kickstarter.
They are.
They have made it to their goal with 5 days to go. But that is exciting for them.
Good for Riff Tracks.
Indeed.
So you can get all that content. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, you can get all of that by going to f5live.tv and clicking the link.
In the center?
You question it every time.
It's up there. If you're watching us on the website, it's up there. There.
Where?
Right above my head.
Well, that's good.
Actually, technically, Riff Tracks is about there.
For our listeners, just Scott's on acid is what I want to tell you.
I am pointing at the ad.
Right there.
No, there.
Really messing with the listeners now. If you're driving to work, I apologize. However, if you had a better internet connection, you could probably watch us on video and not worry about a data limit.
It's true. Or data speeds, because those videos are a little big. A little big. It's an oxymoron.
What?
Enjoy that.
Yep.
If you're in the Tampa, Florida area, like we happen to be.
What an ironic turn of events.
I know. Verizon is actually ramping up their Fios. That's funny. He might be correct. That's on me.
/ join us?
Yeah, that's gotcha. On me.
Well, F5Live.tv has the ads, so enjoy that.
Verizon's ramping up their Fios installations in the Tampa market. This comes after 2 years ago they said that they were slowing down. And then about a year ago they said, if your market's not active, we're done.
Yeah, and we have cable sitting outside of our studio building. We can see the cable.
Yep.
And it's not active.
Yeah.
That was upsetting within within itself there. But now,
so
possibly we'll get it.
17,700 new households are going to get the availability, bringing it up to over 1.1 million. It's actually 1.17, give or take.
In the Tampa Bay area, right?
Yes. If you live in Pinellas County or Polk County, you're in luck, about 8,000 households. On the other hand, if you're in Manatee, Sarasota, or Hillsborough County, all in, I think you're getting about 1,400 new households. So that's not as impressive.
Now, I believe, if I'm not mistaken,
Did I say 1,600? Because I meant 16,000.
16,000.
16,000 households in Pinellas and Polk, only 1,400 between Sarasota, Manatee, and Hillsborough.
Now, we can clarify this, though.
Yes.
When Bright House, we have Bright House in the area.
Yes.
And they kind of had a monopoly on this area back when Verizon wanted to start laying down the Fios. They went through a whole ordeal, finally got approved to even enter Pinellas County to lay the fiber.
It actually had nothing to do with Bright House.
Was it not?
It actually had everything to do with Nology.
Oh, even better. The awful cable company.
We used to have GTE, General Telephone and Electric, was the telephone company. They became Verizon in this market. When they did, Verizon didn't want GTE Americast, which was their cable company, which was a disaster. Nology decided to enter this market, purchased Americast, and part of the agreement was that Verizon was not allowed to compete for a certain period of time.
Gotcha. That's what it was. Okay. But I do know that because of that, we kind of got shafted at the beginning. We couldn't even get fiber laid down, and then they laid down the fiber, and due to whatever restrictions were in place, some areas had fiber run for miles. None of it was active. And that's the cable that's sitting outside on our road right now.
Now, to be fair, all over the country, there are probably hundreds of millions of miles of fiber that have been laid in the past that have never been turned on,
right?
Including in this area.
Right.
Verizon didn't have to lay their own. They could have bought the fiber that was already in place, but whatever.
Now, there is a possibility, though, that Sarasota, Manatee, and Hillsborough had more households already active.
Hillsborough is where it started in Florida, so
that's possible.
That is a reasonable possibility.
Now, Abram's telling us that they have Fios in his neighborhood in New York, but not in his building. However, on Friday, his house, along with the 24 of our neighbors, signed a sheet telling Verizon that they wanted them to wire the building. Good. I wish it worked like that here.
We have interesting laws around that here.
Mm-hmm.
You can get around cable by going with Dish, but you can't go with Verizon.
Right.
There's no requirement for an apartment complex or anybody to allow another company to come in. So
hopefully they wire the building for Abram, and hopefully they'll turn on the fiber. Maybe we can tap into it at some point. Because we haven't even gotten to get to that discussion yet because the fiber wasn't active.
Well, our neighborhood is on the list, so that is a good situation.
Oh, see, I didn't get to check that. We're on the list, actually.
Largo, Indian Rocks, so yes.
Right.
This market is on the list.
Yay. I want fiber.
Hopefully so are my parents. We will see.
He
currently has Time Warner Cable, which is a sister to Bright House, which is who we have. And yes, they are not the best. So
we'll let you know what comes of that. And Avery needs to keep us posted on what happens
with him.
With him, because that might set a precedent. Hopefully.
Be nice.
We'll see. Moving on, some good karma fills the room. We'll talk about that in just a little bit. Got to bring that fader up first. This week's
helps.
Nifty Gifties on F5 Live. Hey, they are nifty.
They're Nifty Gifties.
Probably powered by the Microsoft Store. Hey, did you know that you can get the limited edition Xbox 360 Kinect Star Wars bundle complete with C-3PO gold controller, white Kinect controller, and an R2-D2 Xbox 360. Master the Force, you are the controller. Shop now. Here to make shopping easy with expert picks and customer support for students, small businesses, and developers.
Developers?
Developers.
Developers.
There's free shipping on all orders, so go to the Microsoft Store by going to f5live.tv and click the link.
in the center.
Get your game on. Just hit it on the head like that. That's good. I like it.
I'll run the wire from my house down to your office.
It's a far ways to go, sir.
Funny.
You know, it'd be great if he can wirelessly send that signal our way, right?
Yes, but again, it's a long distance.
But with news that we're about to talk about, they've enhanced the draw distance for that wireless technology, so maybe there's hope for us.
Maybe.
Not 2,000 miles of hope. But
no, probably not.
One can dream, can't they?
Yes. So there's a technology called Qi that Nick knows oh so much about because he got to speak to Fulton Innovation at CES this year.
Yeah. You know, it comes down to it. Every year we go to these events and we talk to a lot of people.
We do.
Very rarely do we talk to somebody that isn't at CES you have companies that have gadgets.
Indeed.
And while this is
a big collection of those companies.
And while this is a gadget, it is a gadget that powers gadgets. So they don't really get a lot of attention. They were in the back of the place and behind one of the big displays, and I'm like,
but they were in the big hall.
Indeed.
So at least that's a bonus for them.
Fair enough. It's where we met Camtroll last year.
Mm-hmm.
So I got excited about this because it is a gadget that powers other gadgets. Fulton Innovation is part of what they call the Wireless Power Consortium, Qi, Q-I. It's wireless charging. We see this a lot so far in HP and Palm handsets. You have the Touchstone.
Right.
You're seeing that with the HTC Resound, has a wireless charge mat from LG, ironically. You see that with the Energizer Power Mat that kind of wirelessly charges things. You have to get the special back and do its own thing. And it works for some models, but with that you have...
The second generation of the Energizer Power Mat, by the way, is a Qi device.
Right.
Not the magnetic disaster that the first one was.
But with all of these different ideas, Scott, you have proprietary hardware.
Right.
It only works for this or it only works for that. Wouldn't it be
great? You get a new handset and you got to get a new thing. Yeah.
It made me sad. I want to use my Touchstone with my new phone. I can't. And I have like five of them.
Yeah.
So what's the fix? Well, making a standard for wireless charging. And that they did that with Fulton Innovation, the Wireless Power Consortium, and Qi. Could charge laptops, tablets, phones, cars.
Right.
Via different objects. And minus the car, you can charge all of these other devices from your nightstand, your desk, your table, whatever you wanted.
If it's a remote control car, you could still do it.
There you go.
Oh.
That's genius.
I know it is.
So being able to charge your phone in a designer handbag left on your kitchen counter.
Right.
Cool stuff. Being able to power not only electronic devices that you use every day, but your cookware.
Yes.
With the wireless charging induction surface.
If you haven't seen the interview, definitely go check it out. It's part of the article. It's part of the show notes. So if you go to f5live.tv, click on the show notes, you'll be able to see the interview that Nick did with Fulton and all the creative ideas they have for this technology.
There's a lot out there. So summing it up, though, you can only charge the device within a very short distance.
Right. That's been its problem. Ideally, they wanted to be able to put this into nightstands and desks and dressers and all kinds of things. But when you're dealing with only a 5 millimeter throw distance,
you'll limit yourself.
That's really difficult to do.
Now they've rewritten the standard. 40 millimeters. That is a massive improvement.
Yes, it's 8 times.
Right. Yeah, but if you think about that in the scale of where they've come from 5 to 40, you know, you can go from 5 cents to 40 cents, no big deal. You go from that small of a draw distance to a much larger scale.
It's 8 times the distance. Right. It's actually incredibly impressive in a single standard right. That's pretty impressive.
So I'm excited to see now the potential that I mentioned at CES, where you had those Behringer wireless speakers. And I was like, well, where do they charge? Do they charge on the dock? That's dumb. They should charge over on a nightstand where you're going to put them, or in your room on a bookshelf where you're going to put them. So you never have to leave that area. And they were like, oh, that's a brilliant idea. Where are those people? And I pointed them down the direction. And it was like a booth next door to them. The
TV company that Alante and I pointed in their direction too. So
right.
We're behind this technology. The the idea that it's now got a 40 millimeter throw distance is incredibly exciting. It definitely enhances what they're able to do.
And now, literally, the possibilities are endless. You can actually charge your laptop, your phone, and your tablet on the same thing.
Just on your desk.
Why not? Just all together. And the best part is you can't overcharge them. They have a smart chip in them that goes, we're charged. We're done. Brilliant stuff.
Yeah, it's and very nice.
So we'll keep you updated on what we see.
It'll help deal with some of the problems of internal batteries.
Yes.
And things like that our good friend Avram Pilch is so adamantly against.
Yes.
And
as he should be.
Yes, we are as well. And
we should point that out.
While we speak of Avram, we should start the music.
Oh yes, let's do that.
And I'll say
you know, it's different with each person that I have to deal with. I don't know what they're gonna say when.
I was slowing down and mentioning his name in hopes that you would hit play.
Well, now say it.
No.
Oh, we're done.
It's that time again for the Pilch Point with online editorial director of Laptop Magazine, Avram Pilch. Are you there?
Yes!
Woo!
I love he's so excited when he comes on the show.
Bet.
I guess I should say this section is powered by the Tech Podcast Network.
Yes, you should say that.
I forgot that.
He gets so excited, though. He's like, I'm here.
Woo!
Indeed. You know, I was rocking out so hard to my theme music there that my son is not the only one who vomited. Listen, if he vomits on me, I have to get him back anyway.
Oh, that's a good starting point. You're already in that mindset, huh?
No, it's cool. He actually vomits mostly on this mom.
Before we jump into this, let everyone know who you are and where to get your content first and foremost, because you've been off for a week.
Indeed. I'm the online editorial director for Laptop Magazine. That's still in business. You can
it's a footnote every time.
Read my column at laptopmag.com/geeksgeek. Follow me on Twitter at @geekinchief and read all of our mobile news at laptopmag.com.
Every time that you have to talk to a client, you are, by our non-existent contract, forced to let them know that the still in business Laptop Magazine. That's how you have to denote your company from now on.
I will definitely do that.
It keeps you relevant.
You don't want any doubt.
Right, and it keeps you relevant, and that's what Google cares about.
Exactly. Like, I don't want them to think I work for, like, Compute Magazine that's out of business.
Wow. Took it back to the old school, huh?
Yeah, indeed.
Well, let's talk about the vomiting child that may sit on your lap at this very moment. Congratulations. I wanted to tell you here on the show, we've mentioned it a couple of times already, but Isaac, the Pilch Book Mini, we're excited.
Thanks. He's doing really well. He's about the size of a ThinkPad T420 right now with the extended 9-cell battery, which means he's about 5.8 pounds. You know, I'm hoping within a couple of weeks he'll be at Alienware M17X size. But for now, he's like, you know, sort of mainstream 14-inch notebook, maybe 15-inch notebook size. He definitely, his audio is getting louder. In fact, in the background a little bit now. He's otherwise doing well. I mean, he lasts longer on a charge than the HTC phone I reviewed this week.
Okay, let me ask you this question. And I know I made the mistake I didn't do my due diligence. Did you? During, I don't want to get into too many personal details here, but during the pregnancy period, did you go and find a doctor that will specifically tell you the size and weight of the baby in the womb as in comparison to actual parts that go inside of an electronic device? Like, oh, he's the size of a transistor this week?
No, I just translated into that. So that's kind of how I conceptualize the world, you see. So, you know, like when my wife and I were getting engaged, I was like, you know, this engagement ring is like two really good gaming systems. Are you sure you don't want those? Didn't work, but that is kind of how, just that's just my sick mindset, or however you want to put it.
I think that is the only way things should be measured from here forth. Really do.
Exactly. I mean, in terms of, it's just a really good measuring stone in terms of weight, in terms of cost. You know, you're going out. Hey, you know, this is the $300 flight. Oh, great. That's the same price as a laser printer, you know.
Be like, well, I'm trying to get down to the restaurant down there. How far is it? Well, you know, it's about 40 miles, so it's going to cost you about a 4 gig RAM upgrade to get there.
Yes.
I'm fine with that. I'm okay with that.
Exactly.
And if it's in Las Vegas, it's a 4 gig Mac RAM upgrade.
Yes. Yes, that's true. Exactly. That's how we roll in the Pilch household. And that's why seeing him and thinking about his life makes me think about the technology and the technologies that I use that he won't. And just, you know, the things that he's going to experience in his life, that, you know, things that were important to me, that he, you know, are just going to be a history note for him.
You know, and I want to commend you for writing this article, but getting into a little bit of the detail and thought that went behind it, you think a little bit different than most people do. Just a slight
bit. No kidding.
And I commend you for it. I think it's great. Coming up with this idea, genius. And writing it shortly, I can't remember if it was before or after Isaac's birth, is just incredible. So he can reference that as his time of into entering into his life.
Yeah, you know, I'll tell you the truth. If I knew I was going to be, you know, off for a few days, and I wanted to have a column in the hopper, so to speak, and so I started working on it like about a month before he was born, and then we had it published exactly like after he was born. So I finished it the day before, and I got my friends at work to like lay it out and make all the pictures, and then they put it up like 5 o'clock the day he was born. So it was kind of part and parcel with his being born. If he had been born later, we would have published it later. I was kind of a, I don't know, write a passage for me. I don't know how to put it. But yeah, thanks. It's definitely gotten a really great response from, you know, the people who've read it, just sort of thinking about like, just, and I always love to speculate about what the things are that are coming and going in technology, and what things we won't be using anymore.
Right. And of that list you came up with, I believe it was 15 different things that he will never see in his lifetime unless he goes on eBay or to an antique shop.
Yep. Now, this could be quite ambitious, but I have to think about my coworker, who's a 23-year-old young woman, who told me that she does not remember a time before broadband internet. So you think about it, broadband internet's been around maybe 12 years. So she's probably, you know, just doesn't remember things that happened before she was maybe 10 years old. And so, you know, yes, today we're using computer here with Ethernet. But I think when he's, by the time he's, you know, 9, 10 years old, there's a very good chance that we're going to see wireless home internet become very popular and replace wired in some places.
Definitely. And she must be a little bit crazy, because I'm 24, okay? And I remember getting the AOL 3.0 disk and popping it in and using it on my 0.2 megabyte or gigabyte, 200 megabyte RAM. And I remember downloading the 18 minutes to download a 3-minute song. I remember all that. Okay. I did that, leaving the computer overnight and taking up a phone line just to download a couple of songs on Napster. Yeah. Did that. So she must have lived in a place that didn't even have that didn't even have dial up until broadband. I don't know. It's crazy.
Yeah, it's a little weird. Maybe her first 10 years were a haze. Because yes, I mean, dial up was just such a part of our lives. I mean, when I was in college, showing you how old I am. When I was in college, we used to dial up, and we used to dial up to BBS's, which was the, you know, the forerunner of AOL. And I had a buddy who liked to download swimsuit pictures, and he'd sit there and he'd watch the little GIF like appearing. And if he didn't like the face on the woman or something like that, or like, he'd stop halfway through the picture because it would take like 45 minutes. Ah, she's not pretty enough. I can't afford the long distance. Cutting this off.
Nice. Yeah.
So, you know, that's how slow internet was, and we liked it.
Yeah. And we couldn't believe that there would possibly be anything faster.
Yeah. I mean, how would you do it without phone lines? Yeah, it was amazing.
Magic.
It was absolutely amazing. And I think, you know, communications is definitely one of those things which is changing rapidly. I mean, landline phones right now, 26% of U.S. homes don't use them anymore. And it's just becoming a ridiculous situation. I mean, why do you even need a landline phone anymore? I think, you know, we got rid of ours a couple of years back. You know, my parents are kind of old-fashioned. They're holding on to theirs for dear life. But I think the house phone is going to be over by the time he knows what happened.
Yeah,
I think
that's
one that's gone for sure.
What else did you have on the list, Avram? Let's talk about a couple of other things that he may not see when he gets older here.
Well, some of these are obviously obvious, like point-and-shoot cameras are being totally displaced by cell phones. You know, I think hard drives will be gone in favor of SSDs in all but server situations because of just the speed and reliability. I also think there's a good chance that remote controls, he will not be using remote control much because of smartphones, because of gesture control. I think that's another one that we're going to see disappear. Also, sadly, for me who loves to build desktops, I think there's a good chance that the majority of desktops will be gone within a couple of years. The price difference between a desktop and similarly configured laptop now is almost nothing. And so unless you're someone who likes to game, or you're like me and you just like to put it together, which I hope he and I will get to do someday, you know, I think that the majority of pre-made desktops that you buy from Dell and that your office buys, I think those are gone as well.
Definitely, because it saves time in the office space for you to not just have a desktop, but you can have a laptop, take home, do work at home, bring it back. Obviously opens up a bunch of liability, but yeah, the desktop for enterprise, I think, will be out, at least in the pre-made sector, like you said.
Yeah, I think a couple of other things that we're seeing in the entertainment sector that are very antiquated. I think primetime TV, you know, just right now, time shifting is huge. Almost everything in my lame cable system is offered for free on demand the next day. So why even bother judging the quality, you know, the success of a television show by how many people tune in at 9 p.m. on Thursday night? I think that is already changing. And at a certain point, dramas and things like that that are not live events like the Yankee game, of course, are always going to be something that people watch live. But I think things that aren't live events, they're just going to give up the ghost and not have appointment television anymore. And I think movie theaters are in some danger. I know that it's an institution and people have been saying that the movie theater wouldn't die for years, but it's just so expensive. The quality of home theater is really now on a par with the quality of a lot of multiplex. And when you look at the fact that they're now getting day and date releases of films more and more, where studios are actually releasing to on demand at the same time as the theater, that means that the studios even think that the movie theater is doomed. So I think pretty soon he's going to, you know, maybe as a little baby we'll be taken to the movie theater, but by the time he knows what hit him and he's ready to go buy a ticket, there's a good chance that movie theaters will be kind of few and far between and that the standard multiplex will be gone.
That'll be interesting to see, and I read it when you wrote that, and I've been thinking about it ever since then. It really comes down to not having the annoying person with a cell phone on, or the nasty seats you have to sit in, or
at least not an annoying person that you can't control with a cell phone.
Right, because you can always hit Scott in the head when he turns on a cell phone. Not that he ever has, I'm just saying. But yeah, I understand what wow, no movie theaters. You know, wrapping your head around that is kind of crazy. Because of all the ones being built today in our area, we have about three that just went up in the past 4 months.
Well, I mean, they may hang on a little bit, but I just think when you look at what the studios are doing with the day and date release, when you look at the average television people buying being HD and being over 40 inches, you know, the social aspect of going to the movie theater is still cool, but you know, here in New York, it's $13 to go to a standard movie for an adult. So you're talking about $13. Maybe you get the kids price, which might be $9 or $10. A family of four, two adults, two kids. It's close to $50 before you buy popcorn. And then you're going in there for 2 hours and you have all these annoying people and you're sitting in a dirty chair. And it's like, well, why am I doing this when the home technology is at least as good? And the movie theater isn't even, and the studios aren't even going to make me wait anymore. Right. I think there's a place for like art house and things like that, but I think the multiplex has really big problems.
I agree. And okay, going a step further, one more technology that we know we're already seeing the end of is the optical drive. What else do you have in that? It's almost on its way out, kind of on a last leg. He's not going to see it before he gets any relevant memories of remembering that he saw them.
I think phone numbers are in some trouble. I mean, I know that the phone number system underlying things has been around for a really long time, but how many of us even remember phone numbers? As voice calling becomes less important, and you know that it's becoming a lot less important, people will be Skyping each other more, using VoIP systems and face chat. And so I think what will be more important in the future will not be giving someone your phone number, but giving someone your user ID. Right. I think that's something that we're going to see the end of soon. Fax machines are like the cockroach of technology. A friend of mine, I can't take the full credit. My friend Ross Rubin, who works as an analyst for MPD, said that when I asked him about this list. And he's right. Those have been around for like 50, 60 years. People are still using them because they want it for signatures. But the end of landlines and the fact that people can now sign the screen with tablets, that's going to spell the end of fax machines, finally.
Thank goodness.
I think glasses, that 3D glasses, I mean, we already have glasses free. Stuff on phones and on one laptop. So I think that you're going to see the end of the 3D glasses, which makes a lot of sense. Now, more radically, I think that pointing device, that the old school mouse, which I personally love, is in some danger because of all, not just because of touch screens, but because so many people are contented to use the trackpad on their notebook. Gotcha. I think you're going to see fewer and fewer mice and more people using the touchscreen, although they can't use it for everything. I think the mouse is in some danger. And I also think in danger, although I personally am quite happy with windowed operating systems, I think the window metaphor in your operating system, where you're dragging it around and it's got the little plus minus widgets in it, I think that when you look at what Microsoft is doing, that shows you that with Metro that people are moving away from that. So those are kind of the things that I think about that, he may very well not even remember seeing, because they're in use now, but may not be by the time he's 5 or 10.
But you'll have to teach him and make him learn and respect that there was a time. Yes, there was a time where we only had a 10 megabit per second connection, my son. And there was a time where we had to take out a CD.
10 megabit. What are you, homeless?
Right. We had to take out a CD and put it in and wait for it to spin up, and God forbid you drop it and get it scratched, you can't get a new one.
Oh.
You can't get a new one.
Optical discs.
No joke, and we liked it. And that's why, if you guys see my Facebook, my project right now is to actually contradict myself by photographing him as a baby with all of these technologies, just as a record.
Yes, I have enjoyed that greatly.
Oh my goodness. That's
we
awesome.
Still have like 10 to go, but I'm working on it.
within, it seemed like just a couple of hours of publishing the article, the first one or two photos was already up. Going, oh, I guess I'm wrong.
Yeah, well, you know what it was? I got a lot of criticism for the mouse one. So when I went home and grabbed a portable mouse and brought it over to photograph him with, I thought it'd be cute. And then my coworkers came by the hospital and they like brought a whole bunch of gear for me to do it with. Been a project for us.
As he gets older and as he grows, you have to get review units in from companies to send to you to match him up against the size of whatever object it is.
That's funny.
Yeah, there's no question about it. I mean, at a certain point, I hope he gets to at least the size of like a pretty good robot.
Not a great one, but a pretty good
pretty
one.
Pretty good one.
Yeah, well, a pretty large robot, I should say.
Okay.
Abram, it's always a pleasure. I wish you and your family the best time with your newly born son there. I can't wait to see him. You'll have to fly him down here with you one of these times.
I'm so glad
you said with you.
With you know, just not just fly him. You can't put him in like a UPS box, which he is probably smaller than the size of a standard UPS box right now.
If it fits, it ships.
That's USPS.
That's true. He definitely would fit in one of those boxes. He definitely would fit in one of those boxes. Very low shipping rate.
We would sign for the package, I promise you.
That's good to know.
Just saying.
Thank you, guys.
You know, we care. Abram, let everyone know how to get your content one last time. We'll let you go for the night to tend to the crying baby.
Thanks. So you can check out my weekly column at laptopmag.com/geeksgeek. You can follow me on Twitter @geekinchief and read all of our news on the still in business laptopmag.com.
Thanks, Abram. We'll see you next week, buddy.
See you next week. Bye, guys.
Never a dull moment with Abram Pilch, folks.
Definitely not.
It's classic stuff.
So, I don't even know how to transition, so I'm just going to go right for it. If you like us and you like what we do, let us do what we do best, whether it be in your home, computer, or iPod. No, that's not it. Whether it be in your home, business, local library,
post office. FedEx store.
If it fits, it ships.
That's right.
Let Plug Hits Productions provide all of your production needs. And I promise our cameras don't usually fail. You can contact us for all of those services at contact@plughits.com. And since Nick is on a roll tonight, let's let him talk some more in this week's Weekly Upstream.
Welcome.
Am I doing it? Am I doing it? More leg, Joe. Thanks, Scott. Hey, this is Nick, and I'm here keeping you plugged into the top stories for the week of April 22nd, 2012. This is your weekly Upstream. After their blockbuster hits like Star Wars and Battlefield 3, EA is going to be laying off 500 to 1,000 employees as the workers were brought on to work specifically on those games. Despite the rumors earlier in the week hinting at a potential downturn for EA, the company issued a statement saying this is normal and that the, quote, headcount will be up at the end of the year. EA is also working on a project to bring their mobile, social, and console platforms all together in one place, and the CTO of the company has already hired on 600 of the 5,000 planned engineers needed to do that since his signing on in October. The Consumer Electronics Association's International Consumer Electronics Show, redundancy, was named North America's Greenest Show by Trade Show Executive Magazine this week following their statement about the amount of recycling effort that follows the production of each show. The CEA was able to recycle and repurpose more than 20,000 pounds of magnetic banners, 28,600 square feet of vinyl banner, 16,000 square feet of other show signs and materials, and for the first time, almost 50,000 pounds of show publications. Every year, the CEA tries to make their CES more environmentally sustainable, and this year they were able to recycle in total over 75% of the materials used to produce the show. That is a great job. Awesome show. This has been a tough week in the cosplay space, with a lot of negative attention brought in from a particularly negative individual. However, we have a positive story from the cosplay world this week, and it involves the policeman and Batman. With the help of A Wish with Wings and the Arlington Police and Fire Departments, 7-year-old Virginia resident Kyle, who is living with leukemia, had his wish of having an adventure with Batman filled. The PD set up a series of fake crimes with Batman villains in tow, all to be foiled by Batman and Kyle, who was dressed as Mini Batman. We have the video on our site for you to check out. Google was given some bad news this week, but totally thinks it means something great for them. We'll talk about that more in this week's DRM Not Included. So for all these stories and more, keep yourself plugged into f5live.tv/theupstream all week long, or click that RSS button to follow the news as it happens on your phone, computer, or tablet. I'm Nick, and we'll be back next week with more of the top stories from across the world. This has been your weekly Upstream. Back to us.
Transfer complete.
Goodbye.
going to be weird again doing this one. Don't cover your mouth this time. This week's Extra Life section on F5 Live is proudly powered by Shockwave!
Shockwave!
Play games.
Like Monkey Quest.
Like Bread That Cat.
I still haven't played that. I need to.
Monkey Quest?
Bread That Cat. Monkey Quest I've actually played.
And look, now available online. Battle zombies now with Plants vs. Zombies.
Yay!
And if you're into that sort of thing, Hidden Object is all there for you by going to F5Live.tv and clicking the link.
In the center.
Get your game on.
I need to correct a small mistake from the upstream.
What did I do?
The boy's name is Kai, not Kyle.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. It took me a couple of tries before I didn't write Kyle too.
It's a habit.
Yes.
So I apologize.
K-Y-E, Kai.
You know, since we took a second to talk about that, let's make sure we do the awesome, awesome thing that they did for this boy.
It's like a 10-minute video, and it is worth all of it. It involves the Joker hijacking a bank, and then the two of them come in and stop it. And the Riddler tries to blow up a car, and they foil that too. It started at like 10 in the morning, all day event. Ended with the mayor of the city giving him a key to the city. I mean, the whole thing
is great.
Very cool.
Just great.
And it was a nice way for me to end my week compared to some of the other cosplay stories that happened that were not positive. So this was very nice.
Definitely. So check out that video. Moving on to the Extra Life stuff. The game we all know and love, Wordament, I think has had great success due to Windows 8's developer preview. That sounds weird. Consumer preview, yes. The game was out on the Windows phone for a while.
Almost since launch.
Right. Didn't really...
One of the first games on, it was the most downloaded application on the platform. Right. And the Windows 8 consumer preview has proven the exact same thing. On Windows 8, it is the most downloaded game, I believe, still. Mm-hmm. So.
And what's really cool is it brought together two groups of people.
Yes.
Because they can all play together on the on their devices and interact with each other and have a universal scoreboard. It's really great stuff. I don't think they expected this sort of success, because even they said it on their blog, oh my God, this is crazy. So they've gotten so big that there are new updates that we'll see on April 25th. And for each day since the writing of this article, which was April 18th, we are seeing news being posted every single day up till April 25th. The biggest news so far is that Wordament has gotten so large that the whole username thing, create a username and do that whole thing, not really going to work for them anymore. There's too many of them. So Xbox Live gamer tags will be the way to go April 25th, which is awesome.
Thank goodness Microsoft opened that API for people.
Right? So, April 25th, if you don't have an Xbox Live gamertag, get one now. It's free. You can use your Silver account and sign up. And you can also play with that Silver account for this game. On April 25th, they'll also be adding language editions to the game. So you get puzzles in a specific language. We'll see the English edition and the Spanish edition going into open beta. Then we'll see Dutch, Swedish, French, German, and Italian editions of the game as well. They will be in beta.
It's a lot of the game.
Yeah.
It's very cool.
And the games will be in beta until they think it's running
sustainable. Yeah.
So, got to get that Rosetta Stone. It's about time. Got to be doing this thing.
You just want to participate in another beta.
Wouldn't that be awesome? It's true. There is also something cool, the Wordament Tournament, which should be touring.
That is so hard to say. I can't even hear it.
Wordament Tournament.
Oh,
the word tour meant. .com. No. April 26th, one day after the new update, at the Microsoft Store in Bellevue Square Mall, we'll have food prizes and giveaways. They should be touring the country with this. Shame on you guys for not.
It doesn't say that they won't be.
But they didn't say that they will be. Hopefully on April 25th we'll have an announcement. If they're going to Tampa, I'm there. If they're going to Orlando, I'm there.
Yes, to the Microsoft stores in either of those cities.
They can go to the Microsoft Corporate Center in Tampa. Done. Wrap it up in a bow.
Yeah, we don't have any Microsoft stores here, and it makes me very sad.
It does, because there's too many Apple stores.
The good news is you can click the link up there.
There. That's where it is. So I'm excited that Word of Mint is getting all these updates. A lot of other blogs.
I play it a lot.
Weren't so excited.
Really?
A lot of other blogs didn't talk about anything other than the gamer tag.
We don't want people who speak Spanish to be able to play.
I don't understand.
What? It doesn't even make sense.
I think it's cool.
Yeah.
Spelling out different words in Spanish or in other languages will help you learn that language.
I like that. They've integrated with Xbox Live totally now. Very cool.
That means we should, and I won't say for sure, but if everything pans out the way it should, we should see Word of Mint on Xbox.
Maybe.
You can connect it.
It would be so...
Because right now I have on my netbook...
That wouldn't be too bad, I suppose.
On my netbook, I know it. I have my netbook that turns into a... It's a netvertible. It has the touchscreen.
Right.
I can use my finger... But I can also use my stylus, but I can also use the keys. It allows me to. It's the weirdest thing. So there's options there. Xbox would be no different. But I don't know. Maybe.
Other than Kinect, that you wouldn't be able to keep up with it. Yeah. It would be way too slow of a game.
But it's still exciting that it's on Xbox Live, so make sure you have a gamer tag now. Most of you should have a Live ID. That's the first step. And just go get a gamer tag. Because your Live ID and your gamer tag go hand in hand. So sign up there. Go to Xbox.com and get your game on. That's three times tonight.
Yes. Yes, it is.
There'll be a fourth.
You're super excited about that one tonight.
I am. Something that's not gaming related. This week's DRM not included on F5 Live is proudly powered by Sirius XM Satellite Radio.
April showers bring major savings.
Still.
Enjoy $20 to $80 off radios for listening at home, in multiple vehicles, or on the go.
It's that same hybrid technology. It's crazy.
Some sort of portal thing. Plus, enjoy free shipping on orders of $49.99 or more. And you can save money on the new radios that we just saw at CES. And by just, I mean a whole quarter ago now. Wow, that just hit me.
Time flies when you're having fun with Sirius XM.
Feels like we were just there.
Now you do it. I'll say the end.
Okay. You can get all these deals and more by going to f5live.tv and clicking the link.
In the center?
Indeed.
In the center!
Yes.
There. There. Get your radio on.
Best radio on radio?
Damn right.
Done. Statement complete.
You damn right. Sirius?
So Sirius is a much better way of listening to music than, say, YouTube is.
Yeah, you can't listen to too much on YouTube anymore.
Yeah, because Google tends to take stuff down when they're asked to. Well, that works out real well here in the U.S.
Right.
Turns out it doesn't work out quite as well in Germany.
Well, let's preface for a second here. What is it? 100 videos get added every second? Something.
It's a full day worth of, full 24 hours worth of video uploaded every second.
You know, so clearly they can scan each of those videos. Clearly, they have the capacity.
And approve or deny. Absolutely.
Each and every single one
right.
can be hand approved. I'm all for that.
Well, the good news is in Germany, it turns out it actually is their responsibility to police the content.
All right.
Yikes. So.
Again with Germany, though. Again?
Yeah.
Germany again?
Saying Google's crossed the line. Shame on you, Google. Stealing people's Wi-Fi data. Shame on
you. What is wrong with you?
Anyway, so.
It's only a $25,000 fine, to be fair.
And it'll teach them a lesson. So, yeah. In the U.S., the law states that a website is not responsible for the content that its users post, but is required to act on claims. Okay, that'll make sense. I'm okay with that.
Yep.
Well, in Germany, not the case. Apparently, Google is going to be responsible personally for everything that is uploaded that has copyrighted material in it. German kind of equivalent of RIA, except it includes music and not, is the GEMA. GEMA. We'll call it that.
GEMA.
The GEMA.
Get your GEMA
on. They filed a suit and won, which is pretty impressive because Google's been making everybody look bad lately when it comes to lawsuits. So right. This is a big loss for them. And obviously the Oracle one will be a big loss for them next week.
She's in trial this week.
It's actually going to be a 6-week trial. We'll be hearing about it forever. Big loss for them. I don't quite know how they're going to handle it. But if their response from their spokesperson is any indication, probably not within the bounds of the law.
Yeah, go ahead and read this.
The response from the spokesperson was, today's ruling confirms that YouTube, as a hosting platform, cannot be obliged to control the content of all videos uploaded to the site. What?
Eh?
That is actually the exact opposite of what the ruling said.
You know, they got this down pat.
Quite literally, the opposite of the ruling. The ruling says you are responsible.
They're saying
we're so glad to hear that the court said that we're not responsible. You might want to go back and reread that a little bit.
It's like they weren't even present.
I know. Well, they're not physically.
Fair enough.
Or mentally present. So, yeah, that certainly indicates that the next, say, 6 months is going to be a whole lot of fun to watch YouTube in Germany. We know Google's not afraid to pull out of a country altogether if they don't like the laws, though.
Right.
So they may just tell Germany, fine, no YouTube for you. Amazon did it in a one U.S. state. They full-on shut their service down. If you are shipping to that state, you cannot purchase from Amazon because they were being forced to charge tax and Amazon didn't want to. So this is going to require them to install software on their servers and process every video that comes in.
They're not going to do
it. In a way different than what they do now, not just taking whatever video you upload and converting it to FLV and to MPEG-4 for HTML4 and HTML5 browsers, actually having to scan the content, listen to all the audio, see if it contains. There's no way.
So Germany won, but in the end, they'll probably lose.
Yeah.
On the grander scale because they won't have access to YouTube.
Exactly.
Well, unless they rescind the order.
Right. Well, the good news is that Vimeo is a
up and better coming
platform than YouTube anyway. So.
Do they verify each content?
I don't care. All I know is when you hit play, the video starts. Oh, something YouTube can't seem to do anymore.
Oh, you mean when I full screen and change resolution, it allows me to change resolution, doesn't skip ahead?
And you don't have to wait 10 minutes for the thing to buffer in 480? And you're on a 10 megabit connection, you homeless? That's pretty funny.
Scott, you mean people still make video in 480p? What professional organization still does that?
None.
Oh. This whole 2K resolution thing is the groundbreaking thing of today. It's never been around before today.
Never.
The new iPad's got a down pat.
There's a name for it. That indicates that it's never existed before.
Hey, let's talk about the iPhone really quick, since we mentioned iPad.
iPhone?
On my,
yeah.
We're going to have to share this on the company, on the show Facebook page, yeah, on F5 Live. There's a picture on my Facebook wall. I shared it with Scott. I made it, but it's real. It's a picture of the iPhone 4S, which is now the iPhone 5. Nope. Same backing. It's going to look the same. And on the back, it's a warning, because the iPhone 5 is going to contain liquid lead.
Liquid metal.
Liquid lead.
Liquid metal.
Yeah, but the state of California recognizes that it's liquid lead and is known to cause birth defects and other harmful skin conditions.
Like Skynet.
May contain Skynet.
Apple is going to become Skynet, obviously. We knew they were evil. I didn't realize it was that much.
The good news is the warning is also in Spanish.
I saw that. That was pretty great.
And it's exact.
Did Carla help you?
Nope. I got it myself. I took the Spanish version of the one for lead and lightly adjusted it. So enjoy that. What else is going on here? So next week, episode 254. Four more episodes of 258, which is season 5 finale. And Michael Scott will not be leaving, we promise. Turning the show to crap from there forth.
No, because that was season 7.
Oh. We'll have him on for season 7 and then fire him.
2 more years.
Got it. We'll fire him on the spot, too. It'll be great. Facebook, iTunes, Zune, any other streaming service, we're all over the place. Make sure you're going to f5live.tv, clicking the subscribe buttons over there for our listeners on the right. Making sure you subscribe to the audio, the video, and all of our social feeds to make sure you get the content when it happens, as it happens, when you want it the most. So on behalf of the staff that's not here, I'm Nick.
And I'm Scott.
And that's it.
We're done.
What a loser. Not you, Alante.
I knew what you meant.
We'll see you guys next week. Peace and chicken grease.
Ciao.
Stay tuned for the post plug.
Post plug.
We're not supposed to feel this way.